Let's talk about what we talked about first with these numbers, because this is talking about you moving into a first lien HELOC that you said you couldn't do right now, according to the bank. Kind of surprising. Your value's at 475, and so they take 90% of your value. It's called the loan to value, LTV. That would be $427,000 approximately. Then your home balance at 310 would mean you have $117,000 left to use any way that you want to or not. Then I took your $310,000 plus the balance that you have on your automobiles left to pay off, and it brought you to $342,350. So after we figured what your payments being turned into cash flow is going to do for this, we figured even with your interest rate on this first lien HELOC, which is about 7.3 to 7.5%, is going to pay off in 13 years. But when you started talking about you had $100,000 that you would be interested in putting down on the mortgage that you're about to start paying on, because you are at that 6.5%, which is absolutely ridiculous, that means that starting in May of 2024, so your first payment, I guess, is in June of 2024. Is that right?
It's July 1st.
July 1st. Okay. So July 1st, 2024, it would, putting the $100,000 onto the principal balance of your current mortgage, would take you up to November of 2040, meaning that you're going to save 16 years on your mortgage in general, but it's going to save you $328,680 in interest only. So that being said, you're still going to be making monthly payments after you start with the chunk. So since you're going to put $100,000 into it, maybe best served if you did eventually move into the first lien and chunk all of it into the first lien, then you're talking about, wow, I mean, a payoff really fast. So it depends on how you're going to look at it. For example, if it's 6 months that you have to wait before you can get into a first lien HELOC, and your interest payments right now, according to the schedule here, and you said you were going to have $85 going to principal, right?
Yes.
Out of $2,000, you're going to have $85. So that means $1,915 is going towards interest only. If we take that times six, that means you're going to pay $11,490 in interest while you're waiting on the first lien HELOC. But after you move into the first lien HELOC, and let's say you went ahead and threw away the $11,490 while you're waiting, what does that look like after you move it into the first lien HELOC and then you put the whole $115,000 you have available into your line of credit? Let's see what your numbers look like then and how fast your mortgage will be paid off.
Okay.
So if you have $342,000 because you would want to pay your cars off, because there's really no need to pay any interest on them either, but that would be totally your decision. But let's imagine that you did. So $342,350, then you have $115,000 you can put right back into the line that is still going to be available for you to use now, because you didn't waste it by throwing it into the mortgage. Okay. Let's see your interest savings compared there. $227,350 would be your new balance after the $115,000. So that's $227,350. Then I'm going to do the interest that you would pay on the first lien. So it'd be about $1,421 for your first month. And then dividing that out, your average would be about $711. So let's figure that you're going to have $800 in interest over the life of the loan, okay? Because I like to see what you're going to start with, which is the high. The very first month will be your very first and highest interest payment. Then as you're bringing this down, it's just going to get lower and lower. So if we average it at 800 and we take your income now, let me pull your sheet, make sure I've got your right numbers. So for 6,000 approximately, and then your total interest, and then you're looking at 2830 for living expenses. 2459 would be your cash flow on 227,350, meaning that this would be paid off in 103 months approximately, meaning in 8.6 years you would have the mortgage completely paid off.
Wow.
Which would be in a line of credit now, so it's not a mortgage because it went from a loan to a line. So And you still have your $115,000 available in this line to use is what's nice. You know, you didn't lose it. Now you've got the whole amount here and you can, you know, buy the next car you need or buy the next property you need or whatever you want to do with this line of credit now.
Yeah, that sounds great. Yeah, thank you.
Okay. So you're going to have to make a decision. You're going to lose the $11,000 if you sit in it for 6 months. But $11,000 is better than $358,000 or whatever it was we figured you were going to lose if you sit in the mortgage for the next 16 years. I don't know. It's a give or take. It's like, I can't figure out really. I mean, if you were to get a small line of credit right now, if you could pick up a $10,000 and just even chunk that or take $10,000 from your savings and just put onto the principal of the mortgage right now, that's going to help you regardless right now. Let's see what that would save you, because that might jump you up the $10,000. Absolutely, that's going to jump you up to October of 2026.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah, so a $10,000 chunk would jump you up to October of 2026, saving you, so you're talking about 2 years and 3 months, right? Yes. Okay. So that's 24, 27 months times the interest averaging at $1,600. That saves you $43,200 in interest just doing the one $10,000 chunk.
Oh, okay.
So wow. That might make you feel better about going ahead and waiting the 6 months. But I am going to ask, I've already sent him a text. I'm going to find out about that because I've never heard that. And the reason I know this is because my friend, I told you, he had just moved into a mortgage and I'm like, what are you doing? And we immediately pulled him over into first lien. And the only person saying he had to wait 6 months was the mortgage company. And the reason that they say you have to wait 6 months is because the loan officer that you worked with, they got a commission off of that. And if you turn around and refi that within 6 months, they lose a portion of their commissions. So the mortgage company will tell you all day long, no, you have to wait 6 months before you can move out because of that reasoning. And I know that because we went through this with my friend, but we went ahead and did it anyway. And First Savings is the one that took it.
I hope there's some way that I can move in sooner to a first lien.
I'm going to write one more guy that I know that does first liens, and let's see what he says. I've got to know the answer to that. One of them will write me back before I leave here. I have a client that will start her first mortgage payment on July the 1st, period. She has a 6.5% interest rate, period. Can she go ahead and transfer into a first lien HELOC now, or does she have to wait? See what he says. All right. So what other questions do you have?
I don't think I have any more. I think that was it. I was just all over the place, didn't know what to do, you know, if I should pay off the cars. But now it seems like if I can't get into that first lien, I'm going to chunk the $10,000.
Okay.
And do that. And if I have to wait it out for the 6 months. Yeah.
Okay. Hopefully, while I'm talking to this other man, you will get some answers from me. Harrison usually writes me right back. But if he doesn't, then I will certainly find out about that by tomorrow, probably. If not, I know it's a long weekend for some people. I just hate waiting on something when I want to know. I want to know. But I will find out something for you and get back in touch with you about that because I'm very interested in knowing that myself. I don't understand that.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
You are very welcome.